Next time you look up at the big nuclear fusion plant in the sky, know this. The sun is actually too cold. Too cold to make the amount of energy it makes. Well, it would be too cold if we only believed the older classical physics of the 19th century. In this Think video, we're turning to the weird and wonderful world of quantum physics and quantum tunneling to understand how the sun keeps making all that energy while being too cold and without burning out super quickly like a matchstick. Sometimes we forget that we live next door to a star. The sun allows complex chemical reactions to happen all over Earth, including the complex chemical reaction we call life. Our planet would be a dark, lifeless ball of icy rock without it. Our weather, plant life, warmth, light, almost everything depends on sunshine, so much so that many of the first gods were based on the sun itself. All of these things that make the Earth what it is are powered through the burning heat of the sun, right? Well, about that. If the sun actually generated energy through heat alone, like a giant fireball, it actually would have burnt out many millions of years ago. So if that big ball of fire and gas up there doesn't provide energy through heat alone, how does it do it? Our resident Think astronomy expert, Dr. Dipen Bhattacharya, breaks it down for us. Like other stars, the sun shines through the energy generated in the middle, in its core. Far from being a ball of fire, it's more like a frantic, insanely powerful nuclear fusion plant. It generates its incredible energy and heat through what's called nuclear fusion. This is when atoms combine together to form different atoms and often release subatomic particles like neutrons, protons, or gamma rays while doing so. We're sure you've studied this at school, but these subatomic particles are the bits that make up all atoms. The temperature in the core of the sun is about 15 million Kelvin, which is 15 million Celsius or 25 million Fahrenheit. We understand numbers like 15 million Kelvin might not mean anything to you, so imagine touching molten hot lava. Now imagine how hot it would feel, and then try to imagine a temperature 12,000 times hotter, something like that. The pressure in the sun's core is 250 billion times greater than our own atmospheric pressure, the pressure you're sitting in right now. And even at that absurdly high temperature and pressure, it isn't even close. See, the sun is made up of 90% hydrogen, which is its source of energy. Every hydrogen atom has one proton. All protons carry a positive charge, and so they repel each other. The closer they get to each other, the more they repel, a bit like strong magnets. Scientists call this the Coulomb repulsion force, a force that's so strong that at the temperature that the sun's core is at, no hydrogen protons should ever fuse together. So what would you need to get past this Coulomb force? A lot of heat. No, not 15 million Kelvin, more like 10 billion Kelvin. But the sun's temperature is not even close to that number. So what's really happening here? This is where we have to bring in the strange world of quantum mechanics. At this fundamental level, a level so tiny that we're talking about the insides of individual atoms, where subatomic particles like electrons and protons also behave like waves. It might make your head scratch a little bit, but you can imagine each proton as also a wave, and the waves of two protons can sometimes overlap a bit. There exists a teeny tiny, teensy wincy, very small probability that two protons overlapping can ignore and overcome the repulsive force through what scientists call quantum tunneling. This will mean that the protons will appear next to each other so they can fuse together. For tunneling to happen, you don't need 10 billion Kelvin. Actually, 15 million Kelvin will do. Tunneling can happen at this low temperature, but just very, very rarely. A single proton needs to wait billions of years before it can fuse with another, but because the sun is so massive and has so many protons, statistically, fusion happens even with this super low probability, just at a very slow rate. So what really happens once the protons tunnel through each other? When protons of the hydrogen atoms fuse together, they make helium. This also releases energy as gamma photons. This process is called the proton-to-proton reaction chain. All photons are particles of light, but within photons, gamma photons are much more powerful. The gamma photons created in this proton-to-proton chain are the source of energy of most of the stars in the universe. This gamma energy is mostly created in the core and then starts a long journey to the surface of the Sun. When I say long, I mean more than 100,000 years. A few hundred thousand years for one gamma photon to reach the surface of the Sun, going through all the different layers of the Sun. This means that by the time they reach the surface, these gamma photons have their energy massively reduced, and they mostly emerge as photons that make up visible light, like you can see. It then takes about 8 minutes for this light to reach us on Earth. That means the light you feel on your face when you're outside, maybe that was made in the Sun's core before the first humans were coming out of Africa 100,000 years ago. There's another critical process that makes fusion even slower, the weak force. It's a fundamental force, and it's essential in making helium atoms by turning protons into neutrons in this reaction. It's also very, very slow. It's the low probability of quantum tunneling and the super slow rate of the weak force process, which makes the Sun burn bright for a long, long time. It's just amazing how much you can still learn about something every single human being and every single living thing owes its existence to. Imagine, it's been only about 80 years since we've known about how the Sun even works. The Sun converts 4 billion kilograms of mass into energy every single second. If it wasn't for this fusion process being so slow because of the quantum tunneling and the weak force, the sunlight we all know and love would have disappeared a very long time ago.